I guess it's time to upgrade my Windows 98 PC yet again, this time with an SSD. Originally, I had an SD card solution in this build, which really is an excellent replacement for an old hard drive. The downside is that the transfer rate of SD to IDE adapters is capped at 25 megabytes per second. Of course, to connect a SATA device to an IDE interface, we need an adapter. Instead of getting a cheap generic adapter from eBay, I decided to play it safe and bought a high-quality Startech adapter. As for the SSD itself, I have this 250GB Samsung 860 Evo. I know it's completely overkill, but that's what I got. So, indeed, let's go all drug one on this thing. So, we're gonna use Super FDisk to create and format the partitions, and for system partition, something like 32 gigs. Name it OS. And then for D, I was thinking something like 125. Name it Games. Yes. Nope. Now, before we start installing Windows, there's something we need to take care of, and that's aligning. And what we're gonna do, I'm gonna hook this SSD into my modern PC and use a program called Disk AT. Okay, the SSD is connected to my my modern PC, and I'm gonna run the Disk AT test now. That's the disk alignment test, and it says wrong alignment is detected. And if we see the details, it shows that the OS partition is wrongly aligned. So to fix this, we're gonna use partition wizard. It's free. And we're gonna just right click over the wrongly aligned partition here. And click align here. And then just apply. And then just close it. And now that we check the disk AT, it shows that all volumes are aligned properly. Details. And there it is. Very nice. Now we can hook this SSD back to my retro PC and start installing Windows 98. I think I'm gonna remove this network card. Only used it once. After that, it's just been sitting there. Okay, good. And optical drive, excellent. So what I like to do is to copy the installation files from the CD to the system partition so that I don't have to use the CD to find some generic driver every time I need one. So here's what I do. Okay, great. Now we can take the CD out and start the installation straight from the C partition. Let's try this product key, LGR style. I love that. One more thing that I like to install in my retro PC is the unofficial service pack. Okay, let us see. Main updates, of course. Performance tweaks. True type ones, sure. Why not? First time I ever did this, I just checked all and it basically jammed up my computer, so I don't recommend doing that. So, you noticed how slow the boot was. That's because after you install the USB 3, it unchecks the DMA mode that we set earlier here. So you're gonna have to do this again. Okay, now we take a few benchmarks. Here's a side-by-side boot-up comparison. How does it work? Or does it even work? At first, the transfer rate was terrible, under 10 megabytes per second, and DMA mode made it even worse. This was because of the 40-wire IDE ribbon cable that I was using. After changing it to an 80-wire cable, the DMA mode works as it should, and the transfer rates are now pretty much maxed out at 100 megabytes per second. Well guys, that's it. Now if you'll excuse me, I got some games to install.